Ida Barini.
And I'm Kelsey Paul.
And you're watching It's Today for WHITRadio.org.
Hello, laser kitties. It's me, Kelsey Paul. And we also have Ida Barini here.
The sick Ida Barini here.
Sick, sadly. But you're feeling better today, right, Ida?
Oh, a little bit. I begged my mom to skip again. She was like, no, go to school. So whatever, I'm dealing.
It's better to stay in school.
Stay in school.
Unless you're severely sick, then stay home.
Then go to the hospital.
Yeah, go to the hospital. Do that. So, our first story is about another royal wedding, Ida. A very, very royal wedding.
Wow, I think all of the world is going to be excited about this one.
Guess who got hitched, guys?
Honey Boo Boo's mom!
Who's Honey Boo Boo?
You don't know who Honey Boo Boo is?
I do not know who Honey Boo Boo is.
Honey Boo Boo? Okay, we'll tell you all about all right. Honey Boo Boo. Honey Boo Boo is a
child
star.
Star.
Yeah.
Star. We use star. That word pretty lightly. From Toddlers and Tiaras.
I believe she's about 7 years old, which is quite young for, you know, a child star, but she got famous doing
pageants. Yeah. Which is a very controversial thing for younger girls, because a lot of people say it makes them seem older than it is, because they do all this makeup, they wear all these
hair extensions,
flippers. They do everything that you would expect more adult women to be doing. And even the pageant industry for older women is controversial anyways, so to have kids doing it is just...
crazy. Honey Boo Boo just blew up on Twitter. She had this famous line called, "It's Honey Boo Boo Child."
Yeah, it's Honey Boo Boo Child.
And then it just, you know...
She got her own TV show.
And she's making money, so good for her, making money off of
her. And Honey Boo Boo's only 7.
Yeah.
She's more successful than us. Right.
Incredible.
Yeah. It's, today's world. Good.
Great.
So Honey Boo Boo's mother, Mama June, June Shannon is her real name, which I did not know because I call her Mama June. And Mike is the father, also known as Sugar Bear. So the family has a bunch of...
Sugar Bear, Honey Boo Boo, and what's her name?
Mama June.
Mama June. Well, I don't know. I mean...
You can't judge.
You can't make those names up, I guess.
It's very
rich. Family picture.
Honey Boo Boo.
And her dress choice was very interesting. I don't want to say it looked like a garbage bag,
but it did.
It kind of did. It's kind of sad. It's called a camo orange tulle wedding gown. It's her style, I guess. So.
The garbage bag style?
Well, it looks like a garbage bag. Well, I don't think it really was.
It's high fashion.
High fashion.
Her fashion.
It's her fashion. Aren't they supposed to be white usually, though, wedding dresses?
Yeah, but, you know, when you have a mom called Mama June and a father called Sugar Bear, I guess you can't wear a white dress.
Lots of things aren't normal in
I guess
case.
Not.
Okay, so...
Still on the theme of weddings.
Yes. We were looking at some songs that you should not play on your wedding day.
Okay.
Why don't we start with the first one, Ida?
Okay, so the first song that you should not play on your special day is Gold Digger by Kanye West. I'm pretty sure that's a given, but I guess some people need to be taught that.
That's number 10?
That's number 5.
Number 5, yeah. Gold Digger, okay.
Number 4, Unfaithful by Rihanna.
Okay.
That's Biggie.
Don't want to be that.
No. Number 3 is The Chicken Dance. Actually, I think that would be pretty cute.
I think it's okay to play The Chicken Dance. Yeah. Some people think it's, you know, unprofessional.
Does anybody know who can sing that song for me? The Chicken Dance?
Oh. I don't want to be a chicken. I don't want to be a duck. So kiss my butt.
All right. I like it. It's, you know, I never heard you two girls sing together. So, it's a first here on WHIT.
I think we should continue that streak.
Yes.
Right.
Maybe we should sing the Macarena.
Yes.
Because that's right. The next one on.
Can you sing that one?
We should do that one.
All right.
You can dance it, right?
through the Macarena.
Macarena.
Tell me. What happened to that? Used to be everybody was doing that at one time, and now you never see it. Oh, all right, here it is, Mr. DePiro, out of the chicken dance. All right.
I think they'll be pretty great at a wedding, actually.
Yeah.
The chicken
the bride
dance.
And the groom
the chicken dance is a classic. You have to play that at bar mitzvahs, at weddings,
exactly.
At sweet 16s,
exactly.
Everything.
Yeah. Live your childhood at your wedding.
Yeah.
So, Kelsey, what's the next one?
So, this one, I think it's okay. It's called We Are Family. I know a lot of people play this at the end of any celebration, really. It's like,
we are family.
Sly and his Family Stone, right?
Nope.
No? Who sang that?
I believe it was the Pointer Sisters.
The Pointer Sisters, okay.
It's not a bad song. I think it's okay. People think it's a little outdated and overdone, but I say go ahead, play it.
I think it's one of those classic songs that everybody recognizes, so
yeah.
It's just fun. It's a funny song if you want to keep your wedding upbeat. Next, we have even more wedding stories. Today's just wedding-themed, isn't it? Okay, so this comes from...
What's number one? We got number two. What's the first one?
Number one was We Are Family.
Oh,
yes.
We Are Family.
Yes.
Number two is what?
The
Macarena.
Three?
Chicken Dance.
Four?
Unfaithful.
All right, and five?
Gold Digga.
All right, we got the top five there. Okay, go ahead.
Okay, so a new survey came out that 6 months after you get married, men, watch out and keep a padlock on your bureau because... A new study has recently come out to say that women try to change your wardrobe right after 6 months of marriage. And I think it's pretty true, actually. If not before that. What do
yeah.
you think, Kelsey?
Well, I could see why some people, you know, don't have the best fashion sense, and that's okay. But when you're...
Women always do.
Yeah,
yes.
Women think
just
they
born
do.
With it, obviously.
So... The items that women most likely change are, you know, like flip-flops. That's a biggie.
Yeah.
I think that...
Onesies.
Onesies.
Yeah. Why?
Don't wear onesies. Especially outside. I mean, it's okay if it's a pajama, but no onesies outside.
Why do women have to change their clothing after 6 months?
It's women changing men's clothing.
Yeah, men.
Oh, women changing men's
yes,
clothing.
Yes.
Why?
Because
I guess
women have better fashion sense than men.
Sometimes. That's sometimes,
not all.
I've
met some pretty fashionable men in my life, though.
Yes.
All right. And
they could probably teach us a thing or two.
Yeah.
Okay. Do women like to change men? Do you think? I read something where when you're married, after a while, women want to change you. And men want the women to stay the way they met them, you know. So men want what they originally married, okay? But the opposite is true for women. Women always want to change men. Do you agree with that or not?
Not always. I feel like a lot of the problem comes from when people start dating, sometimes they don't spend enough time dating, I guess. They rush into marriage, first of all, and second of all, they don't get to know each other as just people. They get to know each other as the boyfriend or girlfriend, love interest. They don't get to know each other as friends. So.
And another important thing is you should never try to change who you are,
yeah.
But you can make yourself a better person.
See,
you know what I mean?
See, that's the trick to
but
it,
it's
yeah.
not changing your personality. It's just making yourself a better person. And to work in a relationship, you have to
50-50.
Change with the times.
Well, what qualities would you, let me throw it out to you two, what qualities, when you get married, and that should be in the distance somewhere, what are the qualities you're looking for when you get married?
This reminds me a lot of that. I was on YouTube and I was watching Natasha, the student teacher, the alumni.
Ms. K.
Teen
Ms.
Forum?
K, yes.
Yeah.
Ms.
Okay.
K, yeah, from Teen Forum, and she was talking to them about what you seek in a... Well, back then it was like a boyfriend, girlfriend, but I guess now it's a husband.
Or wife.
What
yeah.
do you seek, Kelsey?
Well, qualities in any relationship would be trust, someone that relates to you with a good sense of humor. That's important. And, you know, people that you know when you have a good partner, because you can just, like, say anything and you're comfortable with one another. And that's something very important. If you're not comfortable with the other person and you get married, it's not going to work out in the end. So it's important to really know who you are going to marry.
Yeah, I feel like I'd want to be best friends with them.
Yeah,
before anything else. Like, but also, it wouldn't hurt to still be, you know, lovey-dovey sometimes.
Yes.
And romantic. But friendship, I think, comes first. Because you have a lot of responsibilities with marriage, especially when children are involved.
Yes.
So, yep, those were our stories for today.
Hope you
our
guys
whole wedding theme.
Yes. It sprouted from Mama June and it came out to that. Right?
Yep.
Ooh. Bye, guys.
Bye.
Macarena tiene un novio que se llama de apellido Vitorino. Y en la jura de bandera del muchacho se la dio con dos amigos. Macarena tiene un novio que se llama. Se llama de apellido Vitorino y en la jura de bandera del muchacho se la dio con dos amigos. Hala tu cuerpo alegría Macarena, que tu cuerpo es pa' dar la alegría y cosa buena. Hala tu cuerpo alegría Macarena, Macarena.